بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم President Islamic Republic of Pakistan President Rajan from Kashmir Honorable Federal Ministers Members of Parliament Senior Members of the Armed Forces Ladies and Gentlemen I was just thinking after watching this this video that it is so painful just to watch and just imagine what is going on and how the people of Kashmir are suffering. But let me begin by thanking Dr. Maria Sultan and Sasi for this event and for allowing all of us to be here and express our solidarity with the people of Kashmir. Let me say that my presence here is a poignant reminder that we as a nation are together. We as a nation are together in this fight for the rights of the people of Kashmir. We may have our differences, but when it comes to the issue of Kashmir, there are no differences. We are all appalled by the brutality. But we have to take note of the fact that the brutality of the people of Jammu and Kashmir is being described and being turned into, by the Indians, into terrorism. That is their propaganda. So we must take note of this and ensure that the world understands the struggle of the people of Kashmir in its true perspective. And that is an indigenous struggle for freedom. A passionate cry of the human spirit seeking liberation. A people in chains fighting to unshackle themselves. A people willing to give the ultimate sacrifice to live freely and without fear. We stand here today and raise our voices for the oppressed people of Jammu and Kashmir. Not only because, I think this is an important point, not only because it is an unfinished agenda of the partition, not only because India has refused to implement United Nations Security Council resolutions, but because we will fight against oppression everywhere, because we will fight against brutality wherever it exists, because we will fight for human rights wherever they are. The level of violence in Jammu and Kashmir is unprecedented. Over 100,000 people have been killed, and we salute their courage and dedication. We salute, the words are not enough to express our dedication to them, our pride that we take in their sacrifice. This courage cannot be crushed. India tries to divert the attention of the people by raising tensions on the line of control and by other means, as if this is a dispute between India and Pakistan, and that way to, in a sense, hide the truth of what is happening in Kashmir. We will not allow that to happen. We will not let the world forget. Pakistan has in the past and will in the future, by all means at its disposal, keep highlighting Indian atrocities in Jammu and Kashmir until such time that the people of Kashmir are given their right of self-determination. My party, Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf, and our chairman, Imran Khan, are of the firm view that there cannot be a durable peace in the subcontinent without a just solution to the Kashmir dispute. Human history tells us that any imposed solution that is not congruent with the ground realities cannot be sustainable. This is the situation today in Indian health Kashmir. 70 years have gone by, hundreds of thousands varied Kashmiris have been killed, but India has not been able to impose a manufactured solution. And it will never be able to do this despite horrendous cruelty. And there is only one solution, plebiscite, and the world body has already called for it. We also need to take note of another sinister design, which is something that has not been talked about that much. An attempt is being made by India to shift people from other parts of India into Jammu and Kashmir. This is what the Israelis did in the West Bank, but this will not succeed. In Kashmir, the fire that burns within Kashmiris will never die. Kashmir is a story of resilience, and we stand with the Kashmiri people and urge all those who firmly believe in human rights to come forward and play their part in stopping the abuse and support their right for political emancipation. I once again thank SASI for giving us the opportunity to be here and raise our voice for the people of Kashmir. Thank you very much.